He walks to the aircraft, his body, strengthened by the exercises taught at IAM, readies itself for combat. He's deep in the enemy's heartland. As he maneuvers his aircraft to close in for an attack, he has a thousand things on his mind. His position. The number two's position. The enemy's position. His number two's position. Which weapon to use? The changing air situation. All this and at 9G. His eyes, his brain are screaming for oxygen. The last thing he wants to worry about is having a grey out. His hands are immobile by the G he's facing, and yet he unwaveringly maneuvers for the kill. For he has been trained to do so countless times in the high-performance human centrifuge. One harsh input causes the aircraft to depart. Hundreds of tons of steel start hurtling towards the ground. He sees the ground rushing to meet him. But he's safe. He has been there, done that. He has recovered from spins much harsher than ever possible in an aircraft, time and time again, in the absolute safety of the disorientation simulator. Kazovac at 18,000 feet. His lungs are hungry, his blood hypoxic. Logically, he should lose consciousness in a few minutes. On the other hand, the condition of the casualty demands that he concentrates on keeping the sortie as smooth and the time as short as is possible. He flies safe, saving lives, completing missions untiringly. In these unforgiving conditions, the one thing that ensures his safety is his operational training in aerospace medicine. Tiger prowls through the night and goes for the kill, his vision enhanced by the NVGs he's wearing. They ensure that he flies unerringly over any terrain. And yet, he's aware, if improperly worn, he could lose 80% of his vision and never realize it. But he's confident. He's trained. He will perform. He is the force, and behind him the force multiplier, aerospace medicine.